welcome this morning. Do we have any first-time visitors who'd be so bold to raise their hand? Yes, Larry, we got some. We have a brochure that we give you that tells you who we are and what we do here at King of Kings. So thank you for coming and joining us. And please help yourself and stay for snacks afterwards. We try to put snacks out there for everybody. Oh, we have a covered dish today. Oh, gee, I told you it was going to be one of those days. We have a covered dish luncheon after service today. Please stay. There's always plenty of food. There's probably enough food for three times this group. So please, whether you brought a dish or not, stay for the covered dish. Okay. Sign-up book for readers and ushers are in the back. If you would like to help out in that way, please see Charlie. He's standing back there if you have any questions. Volunteers needed for Church Altar Guild. And that's basically the person who helps set up every week, gets communion in that. See Chris Viola? Chris, she here? She's next door. Okay. She's uncovering all the covered dishes. There's also other things coming up. They're in that weekly announcements in the insert that you received in the bulletin. This week, today, covered dish luncheon after worship. Friday, there is a dance in Kyle Hall at 5 o'clock. Saturday is a music jam at Kyle Hall at 1 p.m. Information about Lifeline screening, which will be held on September 6th in Kyle Hall, is on the table in the narthex. Claire Lex, let's continue praying for Claire. She is in rehab right now rather than home, which is probably the best place for her. So let's keep Claire in our prayers, and we'll get an update about her during Joys and Concerns. Do we have any other announcements for this day? Yes. Do you need a mic, please? Okay, wonderful gift of being part of this community. Rarely will you go hungry. There's regularly food out there. Two other new members classes. I'm going to be holding those on the 10th and the 17th of September. I'll have them right after service. Both sessions are about 45 minutes long. And if you'd like to become a member of church, I encourage you to attend those. You can also join by transferring membership from another Lutheran church. So don't necessarily have to come to classes. Any other announcements?
I have one short one, Pastor.
Okay.
He's not a visitor. He's a member who's been away for quite a while. And Bob, would you raise your hand? Bob Bella?
Hi, Bob.
He's been up north, and he and his daughter are here visiting us today, so we are so glad you're back in worship with us.
Well, welcome back to the Sunshine State. Hope you brought some of that cooler air that they get up north with you. Any other announcements? Well, then, I invite those who are able to stand, and let's actually begin worship. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who greets us in this and every season, whose word never fails, and whose promise is sure. Amen. Amen. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of our neighbors. Merciful God, we confess that we have sinned, we have hurt our community, we have squandered your blessings, we have hoarded your bounty. In the name of Jesus, forgive us and grant us your mercy. Righteous God, we confess that we have sinned, we have failed to be honest, we have lacked the courage to speak, we have spoken falsely. In the name of Jesus, forgive us and grant us your mercy. God is a cup of cold water when we thirst. God offers boundless grace when we fail. Claim the gift of God's mercy. You are freed and forgiven. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Let's open our hearts, folks, from the worship.
Glory. Glory. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Please join me in praying the prayer of the day. O God, with all your faithful followers of every age, we praise you, the rock of our life. Be our strong foundation, and form us in the body of your Son, that we may gladly minister to the whole world. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
Please be seated.
A reading from Isaiah. Listen to me, you that pursue righteousness, you that seek the Lord. Look to the rock from which you were hewn, and to the quarry from which you were dug. Look to Abraham your father, and to Sarah who bore you. For he was but one when I called him, but I blessed him and made him many. For the Lord will comfort Zion. He will comfort all her waste places, and will make her wilderness like Eden, her desert like the garden of the Lord. Joy and gladness will be found in her, thanksgiving and the voice of song. Listen to me, my people, and give heed to me, my nation. For teaching will go out from me, and my justice for a light to the peoples. I will bring near my deliverance swiftly. My salvation has gone out, and my arms will rule the peoples. The coastlands wait for me, and for my arm they hope. Lift up your eyes to the heavens and look to the earth beneath, for the heavens will vanish like smoke, and the earth will wear like a garment, and those who live on it will die like gnats. But my salvation will be forever, and my deliverance will never be ended. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us read responsively Psalm 138. I will give thanks to you, O Lord, with my whole heart.
Lord God, I will sing your praise.
I will bow down toward your holy temple and praise your name because of your steadfast love and faithfulness.
For you have brought my name and your word above all things.
When I called, you answered me.
You increased my strength within me.
All the rulers of the earth will praise you, O Lord. They will sing of the ways of the Lord.
The great is the glory of the Lord.
The Lord is high, yet cares for the lowly.
Perceiving the haughty from afar.
Though I walk in the midst of trouble, you keep me safe.
You stretch forth your hand against the fury of my enemies. Your right hand shall save me.
You will make good your purpose for me. A reading from Romans. I appeal to you, therefore, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your spiritual worship. Do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your minds, so that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and acceptable and perfect. For by the grace given to me, I say to everyone among you, not to think of yourselves more highly than you ought to think, but to think with sober judgment, each according to the measure of faith that God has assigned. For as in one body we have many members, and not all the members have the same function, so we, who are many, are one body in Christ, and individually we are members one of another. We have gifts that differ according to the grace given to us. Prophecy in proportion to faith. Ministry in ministering. The teacher in teaching. The exhorter in exhortation. The giver in generosity. The leader in diligence. The compassionate in cheerfulness. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus, I love you.
The Holy Gospel according to Matthew, the 16th chapter. Are you listening, Kayla? There's going to be a test. So you got to listen, okay? Now, when Jesus came into the district of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, "Who do the people say that the Son of Man is?" And they said, "Some say John the Baptist, but others Elijah, and still others Jeremiah or one of the prophets." He said to them, "But who do you say that I am?" Simon Peter answered, "You are the Messiah, Son of the living God." And Jesus answered him, "Blessed are you, Jonah, Simon, son of Jonah, for the flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father in heaven. And I tell you, you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of Hades will not prevail against it. I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven." Then he sternly ordered the disciples not to tell anyone that he was Messiah. The Gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Please be seated. Come on up. Any other children out there? Okay. Have a seat. Okay. Test time. What was the question that Jesus asked the disciples? Come on, put it right up. Anybody out there going to help me out? What was the question Jesus asked the disciples? Who do you say I am? Who am I? Right? That's a good question. All of us need to be able to answer that question in our lives, with how we live our life. But I think there's two other questions that are just as important that we need to be able to answer along with them. And I'm going to give you the first one. Who are you? Who are you? You're Kyla, okay? Is that it? I'm Kyla. What else? Who are you? How about you, Layla? Who are you? Your name is what? Your name means flower necklace. Wow, wonderful. Okay, that's something about who you are, because you kind of like this wonderful little adoration. How about, are you a daughter? Okay, are you a daughter? Okay. Are you a sister? Okay. Are you a granddaughter? Yeah. Are you a student? Do you go to school? Okay. What are you good at? What subject are you good at? Math. So my name is Kyla and I'm good at math. What subject are you good at? Reading. My name is Layla and I'm a good reader. So see, there's a lot of those who I am. There's a lot of things, and as you grow older, the who I am becomes broader and broader and more complex. Jeff here can say, "I was an intelligence officer with the Central Intelligence Agency." Not many people can say that. George can say, "I am a musician." Gigi can say, "I'm a nurse." Okay? So that who I am is an important question. And it's something we need to ask in our prayers regularly. God, who am I? Because knowing who you are helps you to, we were reading that lesson from Romans, and Paul was talking about that God gave certain people gifts to be things. So teachers, he gave gifts to be teachers. Ministers, he gave gifts to be ministers. So knowing who you are, who am I, is a big question to answer that we need to answer and think on regularly. So let's pray. Dear God, I ask you today, help me to learn more clearly who I am. Not just who I am here, but who I am to you. And what gifts did you give me so that I may be all that you created me to be? And let the people say, Amen. Okay, well, you know, there's toys in there for you, gifts in there for you. Help yourself. Who am I? I think that's a question we need to ask a lot of times. We need to ask God, who am I? It's one of those big questions. And we need to struggle with it because sometimes we won't like the answers we get. When I ask, who am I? Well, you can be really opinionated, Jim. Oh, gosh. Well, maybe I need to tone that down a little bit. Who am I? Well, I've given you gifts to be able to speak out. So maybe if you tone your opinions with my teachings, you could actually be useful in the bringing of the kingdom of heaven. Who am I? And that's a question that each of us can ask ourselves and be fearless in the answers that we receive, who I am, because some of those answers will point out our shortcomings, our downfalls. And that's all right, because in that then we can learn. Who am I? Ask that question. It's an important question. Because the big question that Jesus asked the disciples, who did you say I am? I don't think we can start talking about who Jesus is until we are better off, more comfortable with knowing who we are. Okay? So ask yourselves that question this week. Who am I? The second question has a lot of relationship to the first. But first, I want to tell you a story. Years and years ago, I believe I was still an apprentice and on this big construction site. And one of the things I can tell you about construction, when lunchtime comes, generally, unless something special is going on, that all the cacophony, all the noise and the banging and the grinding and all the other noises associated with the building industry comes to a halt. Okay? And it becomes quiet at lunchtime. It's that little Sabbath in the midst of a very chaotic day where we get a chance to socialize with one another, we get a chance to eat something, and we, if nothing else, get the chance to enjoy a moment of peace and quiet. I remember this one day, and I remember this one thing very clearly because I pondered on it quite often since then. There was somebody, and I forget who he was or what his trade was or what his particular job was sitting there quietly eating his lunch by the entrance to the job site. And a big fancy car drove up, and a suit got out of the car. Now, I just gave away who I am and who I am, because I wasn't a suit. I was what you would maybe call jeans and a t-shirt. And we did clarify those, watch out, there's suits walking around the job right now, because you never knew who the suits were. Well, this guy in the suit walked into the job, and he was kind of already agitated, and he said to the guy sitting there peacefully eating his lunch, who do you work for? And the guy stopped chewing, looked at him and said, Mom and the kids. Now, I don't remember the rest of that conversation, but I remember because I went off, I started thinking about that reflection. Mom and the kids, who do you work for, is often a question that is an answer to the next question that I think we need to ask ourselves. Not only who you are, but whose you are. And many of us who are working, grinding away, will answer that whose you are in the sense of what we do or who we work for. I think that unnamed gentleman that day on the job site had a better answer. He was there working to support his wife and his children. That's who he was. If we are gifted to be in a relationship with somebody, a good, healthy relationship, we understand that we belong to one another. Our desire is to supply the care and the needs of our partner, as their desire is to do that for us. That's part of a community relationship. But it expands beyond that. If you're part of a family, you belong to that group. Whose are you? You belong to that group. And it often expands further into where your family came from, who your people are, what your tribe is. But just like the question when I ask, who am I, can have some rough answers, the question of whose am I can get twisted and distorted. And sometimes that false sense of belonging to whom, to whose we are, becomes twisted, and it gets used against us, and it's used to divide us into tribes warring with each other. Whose am I? Well, I'm a Yankee. No, I was a Southerner. Whose am I? Well, I'm a Christian. No, I'm a Muslim. The whose am I can become twisted if we're not careful. And that's why I think the most important whose has to be answered with this understanding. The ancient Hebrews never referred to God the way we casually refer to God, G-O-D, one word, big concept, that's God's name. No. The ancient Hebrews used the word, and they never said it. It was meant to be almost breathed, almost whispered. And it was characterized by the characters, which in English, or our alphabet, is YHWY. And that is often understood as Yahweh. But they didn't say Yahweh. They would say Yahweh. See, the whole word itself imitates the inhale and the exhale. Breathe in, breathe out. Yahweh, Yahweh, Yahweh. See, it was the understanding that God, the source of all life, was related to the breath that was blown into life, into Adam when Adam was created. Yahweh. We almost can't praise God by breathing. It's as natural as breathing. We are breathing the idea of our Creator, the Creator who created all of existence. Breath is one common denominator of not just all living people, regardless of where they come from or who they belong to or what their tribe is. Breath is the common denominator of all living beings on this world. It is that breath, that life that was breathed into Adam, that we still breathe in and out each day. So, whose we are God's. And when we remember that we are God's, as long to all the other obligative relationships that we belong into, now we've gotten to the point, Peter was, when he asked Jesus' question, who do you say I am? See, think of it from Peter's perspective. Who was Peter? Peter could say, I'm a fisherman. Yes, he was. He was a fisherman. And Peter could say, I belong to the Galileans. I belong to my brother, who is Andrew, who is also a fisherman. That's just my obligation. I have a wife. I'm obligated to her. But how did Peter describe himself when he met Jesus? Got down on his knees and said, stay away from me, Lord. For what? I am a sinful man. The who I am has that double barb. And then Jesus said, follow me. And he became part of Jesus' group of disciples, whose he was. So when he says, who do you say I am? Peter is saying, you are the Messiah. You are the Son of the living God. You are the one that we have been seeking for our entire existence as a people. You are the one who, in spite of my failings, in spite of my sinfulness, has called me. And Peter didn't stop screwing up in his life, because if you read this lesson further, Jesus is telling him, no, no, get behind me, Satan. He goes from hero to zero. But he sits there as a good model for us when we ask who we are or whose we are. Because then we can truly embrace Christ as where Christ belongs, and that is the one who came to save us, not just from the sinfulness of the world, but the sinfulness of ourselves. That is the real gift of the cross, that we don't need to have to worry about making ourselves righteous. That's been done. We can then proceed in life free to be who God created us to be. So these questions of who am I, whose am I, and who is Christ to me, form another Trinity. See, that's the beauty about theology, and especially as Christian theology. Everything forms Trinity. I've spoken about love as being a triune relationship, because how are the commandments distilled down? They're distilled down in Scripture as love God with all your heart, soul, and being, love your neighbor, and love yourself. And I contend that unless you can keep those in balance, that your love for God is like your love for neighbor and love for self, well, then it becomes distorted. And Jesus says to his disciples, how can you say you hate your neighbor and say you love me? You need to be able to love your neighbor because you know your neighbor. And you can't know me until you know and love your neighbor. It's another balance. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Who am I? Whose am I? Who's Christ to me? Christ is he who saved me. Saved me from myself. Saved me from my brokenness. And this I celebrate. And I try to celebrate that each day of my life. Amen.
In Christ, you have heard the word of faith, the gospel of salvation.
Living together in trust and hope, let us confess together our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He is seated into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the life, and life everlasting. Amen. Be seated. At this time, and if you've been visiting with us, you'll say, oh, we got all these wonderful prayers in our bulletin, and they are wonderful prayers. I invite you to take them home. But it is our belief here that prayers need to come from the assembly for those things that we are praying for in our lives or where we are praying in this world. So we break this down into two groups: joys, those things that we are thanking God for, we're joyful for, we've been blessed, or concerns, those places where we're asking the Spirit to intercede. So will my beautiful flowered necklace take the, that's a wonderful name. You'll take the microphone out when you see a person's hand. So we have anybody who wants to share a joy today? Oh, we got one right there.
Thank you. My joy is the fact that my good friend is sitting here in front of me. Bob was my right-hand man when we were doing the food pantry. And I'm not trying to embarrass him, but I'm telling you the truth. And I was so happy to see him come in yesterday. I was going to make that announcement, and Larry beat me to it. But in addition to that, all good things bring other good things. We must have had 5 people in the jam yesterday that had never been there before.
Okay.
Yeah. So we're growing, and the church is growing, and we're going to try to keep our part of it going too.
Amen. Amen. Praise God. There's one in the back there.
Good morning. Bill and I have a lot of joys today. This past week, we celebrated being together 25 years. Next year's married 25, but we decided to celebrate the day we met, which was this past week. And we were able to go to Anna Maria Island for a few days. Not our original intention. We weren't supposed to be here today. We were supposed to be flying in from Maui, coming home. But obviously we couldn't go to Maui, and our prayers are with the people of Maui. Our place is still closed. They have no staff. It's horrible over there. Our second joy, a lot of you know my daughter lives in Australia. She's been in the States for the last 2 weeks, and this week it's our turn for her to come. If this storm does not stop her, she will be here the end of this week. So it'll be our turn, and looking forward to that. Lastly, I told you we had a lot of joy, sorry. Her two daughters, our granddaughters, they finally exercised their right to dual citizenship, and they became U.S. citizens, so we're happy about that.
Amen. Amen. Wonderful joy. Yep, right back there. Can't miss them.
A joy I'd like to share with everybody. Me and my wife were raising one of our grandsons, Nicholas. We raised him for about 8 years. For every weekend he came to church with Grandpa. And then the powers beyond my control, he didn't come and be a part of our life for the last 8 years. And now I've seen Nicholas now for the last 2 weekends. He is 6'1" in the ninth grade. And Grandpa's working on him, this Grandpa. One Sunday is my goal is to have him come worship with us, so you guys all get to see what Nicholas looks like today. And I promised Nicholas I would pray for his other grandfather that's struck down with cancer right now and in a hospital. But I'm really excited and wanted to share that with you guys, that Nicholas is back a part of our lives again. So that's just,
amen.
It means a lot to me. Thank you.
His other grandfather's name, so we can lift it up.
Gary.
Gary. Okay. Thank you. Other joys. Oh, somewhere here. Hey, right there. There you go.
I just wanted to let you know that Bob Kelly hopefully will be released from the hospital this coming Wednesday.
Okay.
And he's doing well and hope he continues, but he is really happy to be able to go home. Thank you.
What a joy. Thank you. Anybody else? I want to share one. We had a labyrinth workshop here on Friday, and when I last looked at the sheet, there was four or five people signed up, and we had a dozen people there Friday, and it was a nice group. It was a nice size group, and I'm thinking that people experienced the Holy Spirit in a way, some of them maybe they never did before. So that was just a joy I want to share that, yes. The other joy, at our council meeting Tuesday night, there started to be a discussion that was getting a little anxious about how many different groups are using the hall and that they don't always put the chairs back the way the other group had them or whatever. And I said, wow, what a problem. Here we have this hall that we've been gifted with by those who've been before us, and it's being used for all different kinds of ministry. So that is a joy that we can all be thankful for. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Yes, Virginia, please, right there.
I'm one of those people who went to the labyrinth on Friday, and I want to tell you, I was touched by the love of God. Thank you.
Amen. Other joys? Oh, we got one back there.
Yes, hi. My name is Cynthia, and I'm new. I came in late. I apologize. I want to thank Leanna for inviting me to the church. She was the lady that did the phone during the weekday. Is her name Leanna? Did I get
Leanne,
it right?
Yes.
Yes. So, well, I want to thank her and appreciate the church. Thank you, Pastor.
Oh, thank you for coming. And did you say Cynthia? Welcome. Any others? Now, how about concerns? Are there situations, places back here?
It's a concern. As everybody knows, Claire's been in rehab. I went up there, stayed with her for 2 hours yesterday, and Terry was there. My concern is all the work that Terry does also. She's constantly taking care of her. But, like I said, Claire's doing much better, and she looks good, and she was in good spirit.
Thank you for the update. Sandy is also, Terry helps care for you. So, Terry, we'll lift Terry up, that God continues to give her the strength as she's caring for not just Claire, who's in bed, but you, that you have trouble getting around. So, thank you. Other concerns that we want to lift up? Up here. Right there.
Hi, my name is Neal, and I just wanted to say I have a major concern for one of my half-brothers who's doing some real fighting for his life.
And what's his name?
Bruce.
Bruce? Okay. Other concerns we want to lift today?
I'd just like to ask prayers for my uncle. He's in the hospital and his heart is only 20% good, so it doesn't look good. His name is Marshall Kelly.
Marshall Kelly? Okay. Other concerns? Yes, right here. He's got a mic.
Anna is traveling back to Uganda. She left yesterday. She'll get in tomorrow. She'll be back in about 2 weeks, but I'd like prayers for safe travel because it is a long trip.
Yes, it is. Amen. Other concerns we want to lift?
Just a general concern, Pastor. For any of those at home listening to us or watching us, we pray for all of you that might be under the weather, emotionally, physically, whatever. We just know we want the Lord to touch you and show you the right way.
Amen. Let us pray. Gracious and merciful God, we lift up with joy all these ways that we connect with one another, whether it's through family or friends. When we are able to greet people that have been away from our lives for a while and we didn't realize how much we missed them, when they come back in our midst, we thank you for those who come into our life anew as our family expands, whether that's our family of our home or our family of our worship community here. We thank you and praise you for all this. Lord, we lift up all those who've been named aloud today. We ask that you bring them comfort, bring them hope, and bring them peace. Lord, I asked that you help us all to answer all those questions posed this morning, that we can know and be comfortable and be full and filled with who we are. We also can be comfortable and recognize whose we are. And help us to go out and proclaim who you are, Lord. Help us to do that as individuals and as a community, Lord. Let us always be that community of love and acceptance and welcome. Lord, we pray for those who in this world have been struck down by disaster and strife, especially the people in Ukraine or the people in Maui or the people in Southern California. Lord, we lift up the Gulf Coast states as we are facing what we don't know again, but it's been in the past. Sometimes the anxiety is actually worse than the storm. Help us to find peace in the midst of this gale. Lord, we pray all this, trusting and hoping in the goodness of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. And the people say, Amen.
The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you. Let us share a sign of Christ's peace with one another, but let us also be aware that there are sanitation stations in either side and that things are on the rise again, so we're going to have to be careful. So, peace.
Thank you.
Let us pray the offering prayer as one voice. God of field and forest, sea and sky, you are the giver of all good things. Sustain us with these gifts, your creation, and multiply your graciousness in us, that through the world may find your love. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, who on this day overcame death in the grave and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so, with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. It's a wonderful story to tell about our Savior and the last night he was on in this world before he went to, while it was a horrible death, was also the saving of all of us. And on that night, he was going to be betrayed even by one of those closest to them. At the supper, he took the bread and he broke it. And he said, "This bread, this now is my body. And I want you to do this every time you gather in remembrance of me." After supper, he also took the cup. And he held it up and he said, "In this cup, this is my blood. And it's going to be poured out. But not just poured out frivolously. It's going to be poured out for the forgiveness of all sins of all people. So also, do this as often as you do it, remembering me."
Amen.
We're going to sing the Lord's Prayer, being the last Sunday of the month.
Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
We invite everyone here to receive this meal. There are three ways of receiving it. As the usher invites you forward, you can come forward. You'll be handed a piece of bread, which you can then either dip or intinct into the cup of the wine, which is dark red, or the grape juice, which is more clear. You can also, we have elements in the back. As COVID seems to be ramping itself up again, if you're nervous, that's all right. Rather than coming forward, you can receive there. If you would like to receive of the bread and the wine and are unable to come up, just stay seated at the very end. After everybody has come forward, I will ask if anybody else would like to receive. Just raise your hands and communion will be brought to you. God always comes to us. As this is also the last Sunday, besides just celebrating your baptism as you go by the font, there will also be several people. There's three here who will be offering prayers for healing. And that is any kind of healing that you are seeking, whether it is physical ailment, whether it is emotional, whether it is spiritual, whether it is relational. Come and they will pray for you with you. These are gifts to God for the people of God. Please be seated.
Oh,
I invite you to pray with me the prayer after communion. We thank you, generous God, for the refreshment we have received at your banquet table. Send us now to spread your generosity into all the world through the one that's our dearest treasure, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. And now, with each breath you take, may you more fully discover whose you are. And may you be so bold as to proclaim with all you do who Christ is. And may the Holy Spirit help you to fully discover who you are. Go now in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
We are one in creation. We are one in creation.
peace, share the harvest.